Hi everyone, welcome to Dharma Earth's Dose of Dharma, and this is your Dose of Dharma for today. Regarding righteous conduct, just to refresh everyone, righteous conduct basically means the 10 wholesome deeds, which is abstinence from killing, stealing, sexual misconduct, and observing the 4 kinds of right speech, and abstaining from wrong speech. 4 kinds of wrong speech, and then being far away from anger, greed, and also wrong view, avoiding wrong view. Okay, so there's one question is, Bande, now that we know what is righteous conduct, but what about our past conduct if we have done a lot of unrighteous conduct in the past? So what did we do? Are we going to hell because of that? So, over here, the Buddha actually has some answers to this question. Okay, so I would like to share a few suttas with all of you for us to be able to understand what kind of a condition is this and how can we, what can we do about it? Alright, so first I would like to share this sutta, which is from the Anguttara Nikaya, chapters of 3, sutta number 100, which is a lump of salt. So in this sutta, I'll just, because the sutta is quite long, so I'll just give the gist and the meaning of it. So if you guys are interested, you can go and read it. Alright? So basically, in this sutta, the Buddha says, because if one were to say, a person experiences karma in precisely the same way that he created it. In such a case, there will be no living of the spiritual life and no opportunity will be seen for completely making an end of suffering. So what the Buddha says here is that, when one creates some karma, they may not experience it in the same way where they created it. For example, if one kills somebody or something or some being, then when the vipaka comes, when the result ripens, they may experience some injury, or they may experience, maybe something, they may experience similar, but they may also experience something not so similar. But definitely there will be some kind of a suffering, but it may not be the same like what they created it. Alright? So, because some people believe that, an eye for an eye, then you reap what you sow, so you kill somebody, so you get killed in the future, when the result happens. Not every case is like that. Why? Well, the Buddha say, the Buddha say basically in this sutta, he refers, gives an example. If one person, he takes 1 kg of salt, and then he puts it in a bucket of water, he mixes it up, and tastes the water. It will be very, very salty, right? But if the person takes that same 1 kg of salt, goes to one of the fresh water lakes, maybe in America or in Malaysia, depending on where you are, and they dissolve the water, they dissolve the salt in the water, and they drink the water, what do you think? Would it be salty? No, right? Because the lake has a high volume of fresh water, non-salty water. So in the same way, the Buddha compares, the Buddha is taking bad karma to be like salt, and wholesome karma to be like water. So some people, they may just do a very little bad karma. For example, 50 grams of salt, but they didn't do a lot of wholesome deeds. They didn't accumulate a lot of wholesome deeds, wholesome karma. So if the water is just like, 200 ml of water, so if you put the 50 gram of salt into 200 ml of water, what happens? It becomes highly concentrated, right? So in this way, the person, even though he do very little unwholesome deed, but he also suffers a lot because of that of that trifling unwholesome deed. But if somebody unwholesome deed, maybe 50 gram of salt, but he do a lot of wholesome deeds. So his water, his good karma, that he created, that he generated through his good actions, good speech, and good mind. So it's just like Lake Toba or Lake Superior in Minnesota. When you put the salt, 50 grams of salt in Lake Superior, what happens? You don't feel any effect of it, right? Yes, that is why some people, even though they did something small, but because of the great amount of wholesome deed that they did, the great wholesome karma that they did, so they may not feel that much suffering, right? So similarly, if somebody do very very big amount of very very big amount of unwholesome deeds, maybe 10 kg of salt or 100 kg of salt, but if the wholesome karma that they did is even more tremendous, it's like the biggest lake, Lake Manaswara, maybe in Tibet, or I don't know, the biggest lake on planet Earth, maybe. Then even if you put 100 kg of salt into the lake, and you drink the water, you will still not feel the saltiness of that salt, right? Yeah. So regarding the things that we have done in the past, that is something that we cannot control anymore. What has been done has been done. But what we can do is to keep doing wholesome deeds, saying wholesome speech, thinking in wholesome ways, practicing different kinds of wholesome deeds like generosity, practicing, observing morality, developing meditation, changing your character to be more loving, more compassionate, and also showing respect to others, like practicing the 10 paths of meritorious deeds, like in the previous talks. And we do it a lot, and you increase your volume of water, which is increasing your volume of wholesome karma. Then, when that bad karma ripens, you may not even feel even a little bit of salty taste. Alright? So this is how we can relate to past unwholesome deeds that we have done in the past. What has been done. Okay, then the salt is there already, so no point dwelling on it. If you regret it, if you beat yourself up because of it, if you get angry of yourself because of it, if you bully yourself or suppress yourself because of it, then you are actually creating more salt. So what we want to do is to increase the water, which is the wholesome karma, and not the salt, which is the bad karma. So, indulging in unwholesome emotions because of past deeds is just unwise in the Buddha's teaching, according to Buddha's teachings. All right. We can learn from it. We can admit that we are wrong, but we don't have to, get upset. We don't have to be disappointed with ourselves. We don't have to beat ourselves up because of it. No. That's not the Buddhist way. The Buddhist way to recognize that you're wrong. Okay. Be brave enough to confess it. Have some integrity. Practice integrity and honesty. And then learn from it and improve. And you may fail the next time, but if we keep learning from it and keep improvising ways and means to help us to improve and to overcome that, then that is the way that one improves in the dispensation of the Buddha's teachings. All right. So with this, this is the sharing for today. I hope this sharing is beneficial to all of you. So don't brood over the past deeds. Okay. Look at the present moment, because the present moment is what builds up your future. So hope all of you, wish all of you to be well, peaceful and happy, and may the Super Gem bless all of us to be able to attain path liberation and nibbana as soon as possible. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.